Hey guys, in this video we're going to talk about clavicle fracture and the more pertinent things for the emergency physician or nurse or medical student, paramedic, whatever. First, let's talk about the clavicle fracture itself. The clavicle is this bone right here that goes from the sternum to the acromion. It's considered a long bone even though it's very short. And it's one of the most commonly fractured bones in the body, if not the most commonly fractured bone in the body. This patient fell on her shoulder as she was kind of got dizzy and fell on her shoulder 5 days prior to her presentation to the emergency department. Upon presentation, she could see a big deformity on her mid-clavicular area, big bruise coming down her chest, and this was her initial x-ray. Now when you look at it, there's definitely some abnormality there. You can see right here. I'm going to make it really easy for you. Those are the fragments of the clavicle. Now let's look again at the initial x-ray, before and after. You might want to pause this video and look at them in detail. Now, whenever you see a fracture, always look for the second fracture. The most commonly missed fracture in emergency medicine or radiology is a second fracture, because you see the one fracture becomes so obvious that you don't look in detail into the film. So let's see what else we find in this x-ray. Bam! Multiple rib fractures. You can see rib number 2 right here is a tiny crack, non-displaced. Rib number 3, very displaced. Rib number 4, maybe it's intact. Nope, there's a crack right here. And so you can see at least 2 or 3 rib fractures as well. Now we're going to talk about clavicle fractures, because the general teaching was clavicle fractures, nothing to do. You put a figure of 8 sling or a sling on the arm, they'll be fine and heal on its own. But there are some clavicle fractures that need surgical repair. So before we get to that and which ones need surgical repair, let's talk about the classification of clavicle fractures. Well, according to Edinburgh or Robinson, 1998, there's type 1 fractures, which are the proximal ones close to the sternum, the type 3 that are lateral fractures close to the acromion, and then the type 2s that are in the middle or second third of the clavicle. And if you remember the first picture right here, according to this, almost exactly this one right here, a type 2 biocomminuted segmental clavicle fracture. So let's talk about the indications for surgery. An open fracture, for obvious reason, anything that's open, the bones popping out, needs to be brought back in the OR, cleaned up, antibiotics and everything else. Tenting of the skin. If the deformity is enough that you can see it from the outside, just for cosmetic reasons, you need to fix that. If there's significant displacement of the fractures, i.e., if the fracture segments are not touching each other, the chances of those two bones healing is going to be very poor. If they're touching each other in very close proximity, probably it'll find itself and it'll heal without needing surgery or repair. But if there's overlap or shortening of the fracture by 2 or more centimeters, then there's usually a poor functional outcome, and these because decreased shoulder muscle strength and endurance. So those are the ones that need surgery. So those are the ones you have to tell them to follow up with the orthopedic doctor instead of their primary doctor, because they'll probably need to have surgery. There's a bunch of nice videos on YouTube on how they do these repairs, but essentially they put a plate, a bunch of screws, or they do an internal medullary fixation through an external approach in the front and in the back. But anyway, that's it. Clavicle fractures are pretty simple. One of the more important things on physical exam, make sure sensation of the arm is intact. There's a big vascular bundle coming underneath that clavicle, the subclavicular vein on artery, and those can become injured. So if there's any pulse deficit, big bruises, numbness and tingling, then you need to be more aggressive, get some consultations going. I hope you like those x-rays and you learned something from it. Once again, here's the x-ray of that patient and clavicle fractures. See you guys.